Eugene, Oregon. Eugene is a Pacific Northwest city in the U.S. state of Oregon. It is at the southern end of the verdant Willamette Valley, near the confluence of the McKenzie and Willamette Rivers, about east of the Oregon coast. As of the 2010 census, Eugene had a population of 156,185. It is the state's second most populous city, after Portland, and the county seat of Lane County. The Eugene-Springfield, Oregon Metropolitan Statistical Area, MSA, is the 146th largest metropolitan statistical area in the U.S. and the third largest in the state, behind the Portland Metropolitan Area and the Salem Metropolitan Area. The city's population for 2014 was estimated to be 160,561 by the U.S. Census. Eugene is home to the University of Oregon and Lane Community College. The city is also noted for its natural environment, recreational opportunities, especially bicycling, running/jogging, rafting, and kayaking, and focus on the arts. Eugene's official slogan is "A great city for the arts and outdoors." It is also referred to as the Emerald City and as Tracktown, USA. The Nike Corporation had its beginnings in Eugene. In 2021, the city will host the 18th Track and Field World Championships. The first people to settle in the Eugene area were known as the Calipuyans, also written Calipuya or Calipuya. They made seasonal rounds, moving around the countryside to collect and preserve local foods, including acorns, the bulbs of the wapato and camas plants, and berries. They stored these foods in their permanent winter village. When crop activities waned, they returned to their winter villages and took up hunting, fishing, and trading. They were known as the Chiffin Calipuyans and called the Eugene area where they lived Chiffin, sometimes recorded as Chaffin or Chiffin. Other Calipuyan tribes occupied villages that are also now within Eugene city limits. Piu or Mohawk Calipuyans, Winefully or Pleasant Hill Calipuyans, and the Lungtum or Longtum. They were close neighbors to the Chiffin, intermarried, and were political allies. Some authorities suggest the Brownsville Calipuyans, Calipuya Calipuyans, were related to the Piu. It is likely that since the Sandium had an alliance with the Brownsville Calipuyans that the Sandium influence also went as far at Eugene. According to archaeological evidence, the ancestors of the Calipuyans may have been in Eugene for as long as 10,000 years. In the 1800s, their traditional way of life faced significant changes due to devastating epidemics and settlement, first by French fur traders and later by an overwhelming number of United States colonists. French fur traders had settled seasonally in the Willamette Valley by the beginning of the 19th century. Their settlements were concentrated in the French Prairie community in northern Marion County but may have extended south to the Eugene area. Having already developed relationships with native communities through intermarriage and trade, they negotiated for land from the Calipuyans. By 1828 to 1830, they and their native wives began year-round occupation off the land, raising crops and tending animals. In this process, the mixed-race families began to impact native access to land, food supply, and traditional materials for trade and religious practices. In July 1830, intermittent fever struck the Lower Columbia region and a year later, the Willamette Valley. Natives traced the arrival of the disease, then new to the Northwest, to the U.S. ship, Owyhee, captained by John Dominus. Intermittent fever is thought by researchers now to be malaria. According to Robert T. Boyd, an anthropologist at Portland State University, the first 3 years of the epidemic probably constitute the single most important epidemiological event in the recorded history of what would eventually become the state of Oregon. In his book The Coming of the Spirit Pestilence, Boyd reports there was a 92% population loss for the Calipuyans between 1830 and 1841. This catastrophic event shattered the social fabric of Calipuyan society and altered the demographic balance in the valley. This balance was further altered over the next few years by the arrival of Anglo-American settlers, beginning in 1840 with 13 people and growing steadily each year until within 20 years more than 11,000 U.S. colonists, including Eugene Skinner, had arrived. As the demographic pressure from the colonists grew, the remaining Calipuyans were forcibly removed to Indian reservations. Though some natives escaped being swept into the reservation, most were removed to the Grand Ronde Reservation in 1856. Strict racial segregation was enforced and mixed-race people, known as Métis in French, had to make a choice between the reservation and Anglo society. Native Americans could not leave the reservation without traveling papers and white people could not enter the reservation. Eugene Franklin Skinner, after whom Eugene is named, arrived in the Willamette Valley in 1846 with 1,200 other colonists that year. Advised by the Calipuyans to build on high ground to avoid flooding, he erected the first Anglo cabin on south or west slope of what the Calipuyans call Japoa. The isolated hill is now known as Skinner's Butte. The cabin was used as a trading post and was registered as an official post office on January 8, 1850. At this time the settlement was known by Anglos as Skinner's Mudhole. It was relocated in 1853 and named Eugene City in 1853. Formally incorporated as a city in 1862, it was named simply Eugene in 1889. Skinner ran a ferry service across the Willamette River where the Ferry Street Bridge now stands. The first major educational institution in the area was Columbia College, founded a few years earlier than the University of Oregon. It fell victim to two major fires in 4 years, and after the second fire, the college decided not to rebuild again. The part of South Eugene known as College Hill was the former location of Columbia College. There is no college there today. The town raised the initial funding to start a public university, which later became the University of Oregon, with the hope of turning the small town into a center of learning. In 1872, the Legislative Assembly passed a bill creating the University of Oregon as a state institution. Eugene bested the nearby town of Albany in the competition for the state university. In 1873, community member J.H.D. Henderson donated the hilltop land for the campus, overlooking the city. The university first opened in 1876 with the regent selecting the first faculty and naming John Wesley Johnson as president. The first students registered on October 16, 1876. The first building was completed in 1877. It was named Dedy Hall in honor of the first Board of Regents president and community leader Judge Matthew P. Dedy. Eugene grew rapidly throughout most of the 20th century, with the exception being the early 1980s when a downturn in the timber industry caused high unemployment. By 1985, the industry had recovered and Eugene began to attract more high-tech industries, earning it the moniker the Emerald Shire. According to the United States Census Bureau, the city has a total area of which is land and is water. Eugene is at an elevation of to the north of downtown is Skinner Butte. Northeast of the city is the Coburg Hills. Spencer Butte is a prominent landmark south of the city. Mount Pisgah is southeast of Eugene and includes Mount Pisgah Arboretum and Howard Buford Recreation Area, a Lane County park. Eugene is surrounded by foothills and forests to the south, east, and west, while to the north the land levels out into the Willamette Valley and consists of mossily farmland. The Willamette and McKenzie Rivers run through Eugene and its neighboring city, Springfield. Another important stream is Amazon Creek, whose headwaters are near Spencer Butte. The creek discharges west of the city into Fern Ridge Reservoir, maintained for winter flood control by the Army Corps of Engineers. Eugene Yacht Club hosts a sailing school and sailing regattas at Fern Ridge during summer months. Eugene has 23 neighborhood associations. Like the rest of the Willamette Valley, Eugene lies in the marine West Coast climate zone, with Mediterranean characteristics. Under the Köppen climate classification scheme, Eugene has a cool summer Mediterranean climate, Köppen CSB. Temperatures can vary from cool to warm, with warm, dry summers and cool, wet winters. Spring and fall are also moist seasons, with light rain falling for long periods. Winter snowfall does occur, but it is sporadic and rarely accumulates in large amounts. The normal seasonal amount is, and the median is zero. The record snowfall was of accumulation due to a pineapple express on January 25-29, 1969. Ice storms, like snowfall, are rare, but occur sporadically. The hottest months are July and August, with a normal monthly mean temperature of, with an average of 16 days per year reaching. The coolest month is December, with a mean temperature of, and there are 53 nights per year with a low at or below freezing, and 2.7 days with highs not exceeding the freezing mark. Eugene's average annual temperature is, and annual precipitation at. Eugene is more wet and slightly cooler on average than Portland. Despite being about south and having only a slightly higher elevation, Eugene has a more continental climate, less subject to the maritime air that blows inland from the Pacific Ocean via the Columbia River. Eugene's normal annual mean minimum is, compared to in Portland, in August. The gap in the normal mean minimum widens to and for Eugene and Portland, respectively. Average winter temperatures, and summer high temperatures are similar for the two cities. This disparity may be additionally caused by Portland's urban heat island, where the combination of black pavement and urban energy use raises nighttime temperatures. Extreme temperatures range from, recorded on December 8, 2013, to on August 9, 1981. The record cold daily maximum is, recorded on December 13, 1919, while, conversely, the record warm daily minimum is on July 22, 2006. Eugene is downwind of Willamette Valley grass seed farms. The combination of summer grass pollen and the confining shape of the hills around Eugene make it the area of the highest grass pollen counts in the USA, greater than 1,500 pollen grains/m of air. These high pollen counts have led to difficulties for some track athletes while compete in Eugene. In the Olympic trials in 1972, Jim Ryan won the 1,500 after being flown in by helicopter because he was allergic to Eugene's grass seed pollen. Further, six-time Olympian Maria Mutola abandoned Eugene as a training area in part to avoid allergies. According to the 2010 census, Eugene's population was 156,185. The population density was 3,572.2 people per square mile. There were 69,951 housing units at an average density of 1,600 per square mile. Those age 18 and over accounted for 81.8% of the total population. The racial makeup of the city was 85.8% white, 4.0% Asian, 1.4% Black or African American, 1.0% Native American, 0.2% Pacific Islander, and 4.7% from other races. Hispanics and Latinos of any race accounted for 7.8% of the total population. Of the non-Hispanics, 82% were white, 1.3% Black or African American, 0.8% Native American, 4% Asian, 0.2% Pacific Islander, 0.2% some other race alone, and 3.4% were of two or more races. Females represented 51.1% of the total population, and males represented 48.9%. The median age in the city was 33.8 years. The census of 2000 showed there were 137,893 people, 58,110 households, and 31,321 families residing in the city of Eugene. The population density was 3,404.8 people per square mile, 1,314.5 per square kilometer. There were 61,444 housing units at an average density of 1,516.4 per square mile, 585.5 per square kilometer. The racial makeup of the city was 88.15% white, down from 99.5% in 1950, 3.57% Asian, 1.25% Black or African American, 0.93% Native American, 0.21% Pacific Islander, 2.18% from other races, and 3.72% from two or more races. 4.96% of the population were Hispanic or Latino of any race. There were 58,110 households, of which 25.8% had children under the age of 18 living with them, 40.6% were married couples living together, 9.7% had a female householder with no husband present, and 46.1% were non-families. 31.7% of all households were made up of individuals and 9.4% had someone living alone who was 65 years of age or older. The average household size was 2.27 and the average family size was 2.87. In the city, the population was 20.3% under the age of 18, 17.3% from 18 to 24, 28.5% from 25 to 44, 21.8% from 45 to 64, and 12.1% who were 65 years of age or older. The median age was 33 years. For every 100 females, there were 96.0 males. For every 100 females age 18 and over, there were 94.0 males. The median income for a household in the city was $35,850, and the median income for a family was $48,527. Males had a median income of $35,549 versus $26,721 for females. The per capita income for the city was $21,315. About 8.7% of families and 17.1% of the population were below the poverty line, including 14.8% of those under age 18 and 7.1% of those age 65 or over. Religious institutions of higher learning in Eugene include Northwest Christian University and New Hope Christian College. Northwest Christian University, formerly Northwest Christian College, founded in 1895, has ties with the Christian Church, Disciples of Christ. New Hope Christian College, formerly Eugene Bible College, originated with the Bible Standard Conference in 1915, which joined with Open Bible Evangelistic Association to create Open Bible Standard Churches in 1932. Eugene Bible College was started from this movement by Fred Hornshoe in 1925. There are two Eastern Orthodox Church parishes in Eugene, St. John the Wonderworker Orthodox Christian Church in the historic Whitaker neighborhood and St. George Creek Orthodox Church. There are six Roman Catholic parishes in Eugene as well: St. Mary Catholic Church, St. Jude Catholic Church, St. Mark Catholic Church, St. Peter Catholic Church, St. Paul Catholic Church, and St. Thomas More Catholic Church. Eugene also has a Ukrainian Catholic Church named Nativity of the Mother of God. There is a mainline Protestant contingency in the city as well, such as the largest of the Lutheran churches, Central Lutheran near the U of O campus, and the Episcopal Church of the Resurrection. The Eugene area has a sizable LDS church presence, with three stakes, consisting of 23 congregations, wards, and branches. The Portland, Oregon Temple is the nearest temple. The greater Eugene-Springfield area also has a Jehovah's Witnesses presence with five Kingdom Halls, several having multiple congregations in one Kingdom Hall. The Reconstructionist Temple Beth Israel is Eugene's largest Jewish congregation. It was also, for many decades, Eugene's only synagogue, until Orthodox members broke away in 1992 and formed Congregation Ahavas Torah. Eugene has a community of some 140 Sikhs, who have established a Sikh temple. The 340-member congregation of the Unitarian Universalist Church in Eugene, UUCE, purchased the former Eugene Scottish Rite Temple in May 2010. Renovated it, and began services there in September 2012. Sarahanaingma Buddhist Temple in Eugene opened in 2012 in the former site of the Unitarian Universalist Church. About 82% of Eugene residents are eligible voters. Of those registered to vote, about 43% are registered Democrat, 25% Republican, 25% non-affiliated, with about 7% registered to third parties. Environmental activism. In January 2006, the FBI conducted Operation Backfire, leading to federal indictment of 11 people, all members of a Eugene-based cell of the Earth Liberation Front, ELF. Operation Backfire was the largest investigation into radical underground environmental groups in United States history. Ongoing trials of accused eco-terrorists kept Eugene in the spotlight for a few years. Eugene's largest employers are Peace Health Medical Group, the University of Oregon, and the Eugene School District. Eugene's largest industries are wood products manufacturing and recreational vehicle manufacturing. Lucky's Club Cigar Store is one of the oldest bars in Oregon. Tad Lucky, Sr., purchased it in 1911, making it one of the oldest businesses in Eugene. The Club Cigar, as it was called in the late 19th century, was for many years a men-only salon. It survived both the Great Depression and Prohibition, partly because Eugene was a dry town before the end of Prohibition. Corporate headquarters for the employee-owned Bi-Mart Corporation and family-owned Market of Choice remain in Eugene. Eugene has quickly made a name for itself as a culinary hub in Oregon. The city has over 25 breweries, offers a variety of fine dining options with a local focus, and is surrounded by award-winning wineries. Popular local ingredients include fiddleheads, salmon, blackberries, marionberries, hazelnuts, and mushrooms. The most notable fungi here is the truffle. In fact, Eugene is so well known for truffles that the city hosts the annual Oregon Truffle Festival in January. Organically Grown Company, the largest distributor of organic fruits and vegetables in the Northwest, started in Eugene in 1978 as a nonprofit co-op for organic farmers. Notable local food processors, many of whom manufacture certified organic products, include Golden Temple, Yogi Tea, Mary Hempster's and Springfield Creamery, Nancy's Yogurt and owned by the Kesey family, and Mountain Rose Herbs. Until July 2008, Hynix Semiconductor America had operated a large semiconductor plant in West Eugene. In late September 2009, Unichem of South Korea announced its intention to purchase the Hynix site for solar cell manufacturing. However, this deal fell through and as of late 2012, is no longer planned. In 2015, semiconductor manufacturer Broadcom purchased the plant with plans to upgrade and reopen it. The company abandoned these plans and put it up for sale in November 2016. The footwear repair product Shugu is manufactured by Eclectic Products, based in Eugene. Run Gum, an energy gum created for runners, also began its life in Eugene. Run Gum was created by track athlete Nick Simmons and track and field coach Sam LaPre in 2014. Burley Design LLC produces bicycle trailers and was founded in Eugene by Alan Schultz out of a Saturday market business in 1978. Eugene is also the birthplace and home of Bike Friday bicycle manufacturer Green Gear Cycling. Many multinational businesses were launched in Eugene. Some of the most famous include Nike, Taco Time, and Broderbund Software. In 2012, the Eugene metro region was dubbed the Silicon Shire for its growing tech industry. According to Eugene's 2017 Comprehensive Annual Financial Report, the city's top employers are: Eugene has a significant population of people in pursuit of alternative ideas and a large original hippie population. Beginning in the 1960s, the countercultural ideas and viewpoints espoused by Ken Kesey became established as the seminal elements of the vibrant social tapestry that continue to define Eugene. The Merry Prankster, as Kesey was known, has arguably left the most indelible imprint of any cultural icon in his hometown. He is best known as the author of One Flew Over the Cuckoo's Nest and is the male protagonist in Tom Wolfe's The Electric Kool-Aid Acid Test. In 2005, the city council unanimously approved a new slogan for the city: World's Greatest City for the Arts and Outdoors. While Eugene has a vibrant arts community for a city its size, and is well situated near many outdoor opportunities, this slogan was frequently criticized by locals as embarrassing and ludicrous. In early 2010, the slogan was changed to A Great City for the Arts and Outdoors. Eugene Saturday Market, open every Saturday from April through November, was founded in 1970 as the first Saturday market in the United States. It is adjacent to the Lane County Farmers Market in downtown Eugene. All vendors must create or grow all their own products. The market reappears as the holiday market between Thanksgiving and New Year's in the Lane County Events Center at the fairgrounds. Eugene is noted for its community inventiveness. Many U.S. trends in community development originated in Eugene. The University of Oregon's participatory planning process, known as the Oregon Experiment, was the result of student protests in the early 1970s. The book of the same name is a major document in modern Enlightenment thinking in planning and architectural circles. The process, still used by the university in modified form, was created by Christopher Alexander, whose works also directly inspired the creation of the wiki. Some research for the book A Pattern Language, which inspired the design patterns movement and extreme programming, was done by Alexander and Eugene. Not coincidentally, those engineering movements also had origins here. Decades after its publication, A Pattern Language is still one of the best-selling books in urban design. In the 1970s, Eugene was packed with cooperative and community projects. It still has small natural food stores in many neighborhoods, some of the oldest student cooperatives in the country, and alternative schools have been part of the school district since 1971. The Old Growers Market, downtown near the Amtrak Depot, is the only food cooperative in the U.S. with no employees. It is possible to see Eugene's trend-setting nonprofit tendencies in much newer projects, such as the Tango Center and the Center for Appropriate Transport. In 2006, an initiative began to create a tenant-run development process for downtown Eugene. In the fall of 2003, neighbors noticed an unassuming 2-acre remnant orchard tucked into the friendly area neighborhood had been put up for sale by owner, a resident of New York City. Learning a prospective buyer had plans to build several houses on the property, they formed a non-profit organization called Madison Meadow in June 2004 in order to buy the property and preserve it as undeveloped space in perpetuity. In 2007, their effort was named third best community effort by the Eugene Weekly, and by the end of 2008 they had raised enough money to purchase the property. The city of Eugene has an active neighborhood program. Several neighborhoods are known for their green activism. Friendly Neighborhood has a highly popular neighborhood garden established on the right-of-way of a street never built. There are a number of community gardens on public property. Amazon neighborhood has a former church turned into a community center. Whitaker hosts a housing co-op that dates from the early 1970s that has repurposed both their parking lots into food production and play space. An unusual eco-village with natural building techniques and large shared garden can be found in Jefferson Westside neighborhood. A several block area in the River Road neighborhood is known as a permaculture hotspot with an increasing number of suburban homes trading grass for garden, installing rainwater catchment systems, food-producing landscapes and solar retrofits. Several sites have planted gardens by removing driveways. Citizen volunteers are working with the City of Eugene to restore a 65-tree filbert grove on public property. There are deepening social and economic networks in the neighborhood. Eugene museums include the University of Oregon's Jordan Schnitzer Museum of Art and Museum of Natural and Cultural History, the Oregon Air and Space Museum, Lane County History Museum, Maud Kearns Art Center, Shelton McMurphy Johnson House, and the Eugene Science Center. Eugene is home to numerous cultural organizations, including the Eugene Symphony, the Eugene Ballet, the Eugene Opera, the Eugene Concert Choir, the Northwest Christian University Community Choir, the Oregon Mozart Players, the Oregon Bach Festival, the Oregon Children's Choir, the Eugene-Springfield Youth Orchestras, Ballet Fantastique and Oregon Festival of American Music. Principal performing arts venues include the Halt Center for the Performing Arts, the John G. Shedd Institute for the Arts, the Shedd, Matthew Knight Arena, Beale Concert Hall and the Erb Memorial Union Ballroom in the University of Oregon campus, the McDonald Theater, and WOW Hall. A number of live theater groups are based in Eugene, including Free Shakespeare in the Park, Oregon Contemporary Theater, the Very Little Theater, Actors Cabaret, LCC Theater, Rose Children's Theater, and University Theater. Each has its own performance venue. Because of its status as a college town, Eugene has been home to many music genres, musicians and bands, ranging from electronic dance music such as dubstep and drum and bass to garage rock, hip-hop, folk and heavy metal. Eugene also has a growing reggae and street performing bluegrass and jug band scene. Multi-genre act The Cherry Pop and Daddies became a prominent figure in Eugene's music scene and became the house band at Eugene's WOW Hall. In the late 1990s, their contributions to the swing revival movement propelled them to national stardom. Rock band Floater originated in Eugene, as did the Robert Cray Blues Band. Doom metal band Yab is among the leaders of the Eugene heavy music scene. Eugene is home to classical gas composer and two-time Grammy Award winner Mason Williams, who spent his years as a youth living between his parents in Oak Ridge, Oregon, and Oklahoma. Mason Williams puts on a yearly Christmas show at the Halt Center for Performing Arts with a full orchestra produced by author, audio engineer and University of Oregon professor Don Litarski. Dick Hyman, noted jazz pianist and musical director for many of Woody Allen's films, designs and hosts the annual Now Hear This Jazz Festival at the Oregon Festival of American Music, OFAM. OFAM and the Halt Center routinely draw major jazz talent for concerts. Eugene is also home to a large Zimbabwean music community. Sinhiri Cultural Arts Center, which is dedicated to the music and people of Zimbabwe, is based in Eugene. Eugene's visual arts community is supported by over 20 private art galleries and several organizations, including Maud Kearns Arts Center, Lane Arts Council, DIVA, the Downtown Initiative for the Visual Arts, and the Eugene Glass School. Annual visual arts events included the Mayor's Art Show and Art in the Vineyard. The Mayor's Art Show is now canceled, as is the Eugene Celebration. The city's public visual arts venue, the Jacobs Gallery, has also closed. The Art in the Vineyard event continues. In 2015, installations from a group of Eugene-based artists known as Light at Play were showcased in several events around the world as part of the International Year of Light, including displays at the Smithsonian and the National Academy of Sciences. The Eugene area has been used as a filming location for several Hollywood films, most famously for 1978's National Lampoon's Animal House, which was also filmed in nearby Cottage Grove. John Belushi had the idea for the film The Blues Brothers during filming of Animal House when he happened to meet Curtis Salgado at what was then the Eugene Hotel. Getting Straight, starring Elliot Gould and Candice Bergen, was filmed at Lane Community College in 1969. As the campus was still under construction at the time, the occupation scenes were easier to shoot. The chicken salad on toast scene in the 1970 Jack Nicholson movie Five Easy Pieces was filmed at the Denny's restaurant at the Southern I-5 freeway interchange near Glenwood. Nicholson directed the 1971 film Drive, he said in Eugene. How to Beat the High Companies of Living, starring Jane Curtin, Jessica Lange, and Susan St. James, was filmed in Eugene in the fall of 1979. Locations visible in the film include Valley River Center, which is a driving force in the plot, Skinner Butte and Yaupa Terrace, the Willamette River and River Road Hardware. Several track and field movies have used Eugene as a setting and or a filming location. Personal Best, starring Mariel Hemingway, was filmed in Eugene in 1982. The film centered on a group of women who are trying to qualify for the Olympic track and field team. Two track and field movies about the life of Steve Prefontaine, Prefontaine and Without Limits were released within a year of each other in 1997 to 1998. Kenny Moore, Eugene-trained Olympic runner and co-star in Prefontaine, co-wrote the screenplay for Without Limits. Prefontaine was filmed in Washington because the Without Limits production bought out Hayward Field for the summer to prevent its competition from shooting there. Kenny Moore also wrote a biography of Bill Bowerman, played in Without Limits by Donald Sutherland back in Eugene 20 years after he had appeared in Animal House. Moore had also had a role in Personal Best. Stealing Time, a 2003 independent film, was partially filmed in Eugene. When the film premiered in June 2001 at the Seattle International Film Festival, it was titled Rennie's Landing after a popular bar near the University of Oregon campus. The title was changed for its DVD release. Xerophilia was filmed in Eugene in 2006. Eugene's Oregon Ducks are part of the Pac-12 Conference, Pac-12. American football is especially popular, with intense rivalries between the Ducks and both Oregon State University Beavers and the University of Washington Huskies. Upson Stadium is home to Duck football, with a seating capacity of 54,000 but has had over 60,000 with standing room only. The basketball arena, MacArthur Court, was built in 1926. The arena was replaced by the Matthew Knight Arena in late 2010. For nearly 40 years, Eugene has been the track and field capital of the world. Oregon's most famous track icon is the late world-class distance runner Steve Prefontaine, who was killed in a car crash in 1975. Eugene's jogging trails include Pre's Trail in Alton Baker Park, Rexius Trail, the Adidas Oregon Trail, and the Ridgeline Trail. Jogging was introduced to the U.S. through Eugene, brought from New Zealand by Bill Bowerman, who wrote the best-selling book Jogging, and coached the champion University of Oregon track and cross-country teams. During Bowerman's tenure, his men of Oregon won 24 individual NCAA titles, including titles in 15 out of the 19 events contested. During Bowerman's 24 years at Oregon, his track teams finished in the top 10 at the NCAA championships 16 times, including 14 titles, 1962, 64, 65, 70, and two second-place trophies. His teams also posted a dual meet record of 114-20. Bowerman also invented the waffle sole for running shoes in Eugene, and with Oregon alumnus Phil Knight founded shoe giant Nike. Eugene's miles of running trails, through its unusually large park system, are the most extensive in the U.S. The city has dozens of running clubs. The climate is cool and temperate, good both for jogging and record setting. Eugene is home to the University of Oregon's Hayward Field Track, which hosts numerous collegiate and amateur track and field meets throughout the year, most notably the Prefontaine Classic. Hayward Field was host to the 2004 AAU Junior Olympic Games, the 1989 World Masters Athletics Championships, the track and field events of the 1998 World Masters Games, the 2006 Pacific 10 Track and Field Championships, the 1971, 1975, 1986, 1993, 1999, 2001, 2009, and 2011 USA Outdoor Track and Field Championships and the 1972, 1976, 1980, 2008, 2012, and 2016 U.S. Olympic Trials. On April 16, 2015, it was announced by the IAAF that Eugene had been awarded the right to host the 2021 World Championships in Athletics. The city bid for the 2019 event but lost narrowly to Doha, Qatar. Eugene is also home to the Eugene Emeralds, a short-season Class A minor league baseball team. The EMS play their home games in Park Park, also the home of the University of Oregon baseball team. The Nationwide Tours golfing event Oregon Classic takes place at Shadow Hills Country Club, just north of Eugene. The event has been played every year since 1998, except in 2001 when it was slated to begin the day after the 9/11 terrorist attacks. The top 20 players from the nationwide tour are promoted to the PA Tour for the following year. The Eugene Junior Generals, a Tier 3 junior ice hockey team belonging to the Northern Pacific Hockey League, NPHL, consisting of 8 teams throughout Oregon and Washington, plays at the Lane County Ice Center. The following table lists some sports clubs in Eugene and their usual home venue. Spencer Butte Park at the southern edge of town provides access to Spencer Butte, a dominant feature of Eugene's skyline. Hendricks Park, situated on a knoll to the east of downtown, is known for its rhododendron garden and nearby memorial to Steve Prefontaine, known as Pre's Rock, where the legendary University of Oregon runner was killed in an auto accident. Alton Baker Park, next to the Willamette River, contains Pre's Trail. Also next to the Willamette are Skinner Butte Park and the Owen Memorial Rose Garden, which is home to more than 4,500 roses of over 400 varieties, as well as the 150-year-old Black Tartarian Cherry Tree, an Oregon Heritage Tree. The city of Eugene maintains an urban forest. The University of Oregon campus is an arboretum, with over 500 species of trees. The city operates and maintains scenic hiking trails that pass through and across the ridges of a cluster of hills in the southern portion of the city, on the fringe of residential neighborhoods. Some trails allow biking, and others are for hikers and runners only. The nearest ski resort, Willamette Pass, is 1 hour from Eugene by car. On the way, along Oregon Route 58, are several reservoirs and lakes, the Oak Ridge Mountain Bike Trails, hot springs, and waterfalls within Willamette National Forest. Eugene residents also frequent Udo and Mount Bachelor ski resorts. The Three Sisters Wilderness, the Oregon Dunes National Recreation Area, and Smith Rock are just a short drive away. In 1944, Eugene adopted a council-manager form of government, replacing the day-to-day management of city affairs by the part-time mayor and volunteer city council with a full-time professional city manager. The subsequent history of Eugene city government has largely been one of the dynamics, often contentious, between city manager, the mayor and city council. The mayor of Eugene is Lucy Vinies, who has been in office since winning the popular vote in 2017. Recent mayors include Edwin Cohn, 1958-69, Leigh Anderson, 1969-77, Gus Keller, 1977-84, Brian Obie, 1985-88, Jeff Miller, 1989-92, Ruth Bascom, 1993-96, Jim Torrey, 1997-2004, and Kitty Piercy 2005-2017. John Ruiz has been the city manager since April 2008. 10 other people have held the city manager position. They were Dean Seeger, 1945-49, Orrin King, 1949-53, Robert Finlayson, 1953-59, Hugh McKinley, 1959-75, Charles Henry, 1975-80, Mike Gleason, 1981-96, Vicki Elmer, 1996-98, Jim Johnson, 1998-2002, Dennis Taylor, 2002-2007, Angel Jones, 2007-2008. Mayor, Lucy Vinies. The Eugene Police Department, EPD, is the city's law enforcement and public safety agency. The Lane County Sheriff's Office also has its headquarters in Eugene. The University of Oregon is served by the University of Oregon Police Department, UOPD, and EPD has a police station in the West University District near campus. Lane Community College is served by the Lane Community College Public Safety Department. The Oregon State Police have a presence in the rural areas and highways around the Eugene metro area. The Limited Downtown Station and the UMCS lines are patrolled by limited transit officers. Eugene City Hall was abandoned in 2012 for reasons of structural integrity, energy efficiency, and obsolete size. Various offices of city government became tenants in 8 other buildings. Eugene is home to the University of Oregon. Other institutions of higher learning include Northwest Christian University, Lane Community College, New Hope Christian College, Gutenberg College, and Pacific University's Eugene campus. The Eugene School District includes 4 full-service high schools, Churchill, North Eugene, Sheldon, and South Eugene, and many alternative education programs, such as international schools and charter schools. Foreign language immersion programs in the district are available in Spanish, French, Chinese, and Japanese. The Bethel School District serves children in the Bethel neighborhood on the northwest edge of Eugene. The district is home to the traditional Willamette High School and the alternative Kalapuya High School. There are 11 schools in this district. Eugene also has several private schools, including the Eugene Waldorf School, the Outdoor High School, Eugene Montessori, Far Horizon Montessori, Eugene Sudbury School, Wellsprings Friends School, Oak Hill School, and the Little French School. Parochial schools in Eugene include Marist Catholic High School, O'Hara Catholic Elementary School, Eugene Christian School, and St. Paul Parish School. The largest library in Oregon is the University of Oregon's Knight Library, with collections totaling more than 3 million volumes and over 100,000 audio and video items. The Eugene Public Library moved into a new, larger building downtown in 2002. The four-story library is an increase from. There are also two branches of the Eugene Public Library, the Sheldon Branch Library in the neighborhood of Calyoung/Sheldon, and the Bethel Branch Library, in the neighborhood of Bethel. Eugene also has the Lane County Law Library. The largest newspaper serving the area is the Register Guard, a daily newspaper with a circulation of about 70,000, published independently by the Baker family of Eugene until 2018, before being acquired by Gatehouse Media. Other newspapers serving the area include the Eugene Weekly, the Emerald, the student-run independent newspaper at the University of Oregon, now published on Mondays and Thursdays, the Torch, the student-run newspaper at Lane Community College, the Ignite, the newspaper at New Hope Christian College, and the Beacon Bolt, the student-run newspaper at Northwest Christian University. Eugene Magazine, Lifestyle Quarterly, Eugene Living, and Sustainable Home and Garden magazines also serve the area. Adelante Latino is a Spanish-language newspaper in Eugene that serves all of Lane County. Local television stations include KMTR, NBC, GVL, CBS, KLSR-TV, Fox, KVCD, KETSI, ABC, KEP, PBS, and KTBC, Independent. The local NPR affiliates are KOP and KLCC. Radio station KRVM is an affiliate of Jefferson Public Radio, based at Southern Oregon University. The Pacifica radio affiliate is the University of Oregon student-run radio station, KWVA. Additionally, the community supports two other radio stations, KWAX Classical and KRVM-FM, alternative AM stations, FM stations. Lane Transit District, Limited, a public transportation agency formed in 1970, covers of Lane County, including Cresswell, Cottage Grove, Junction City, Veneta, and Blue River. Operating more than 90 buses during peak hours, Limited carries riders on 3.7 million trips every year. Limited also operates a bus rapid transit line that runs between Eugene and Springfield, Emerald Express, Inks, much of which runs in its own lane. Limited's main terminus in Eugene is at the Eugene Station. Limited also offers paratransit. Cycling is popular in Eugene and many people commute by bicycle. Summertime events and festivals frequently have bike parking corrals that are often filled to capacity by 300 or more bikes. Many people commute to work by bicycle every month of the year. Numerous bike shops provide the finest rain gear products, running lights, and everything a biker needs to ride and stay comfortable in the damp, misty climate. Bike trails take commuting and recreational bikers along the Willamette River past a scenic rose garden, along Amazon Creek, through the downtown, and through the University of Oregon campus. In 2009, the League of American Bicyclists cited Eugene as one of 10 gold-level cities in the U.S. because of its remarkable commitments to bicycling. In 2010, Bicycling Magazine named Eugene the fifth most bike-friendly city in America. The U.S. Census Bureau's annual American Community Survey reported that Eugene had a bicycle commuting mode share of 7.3% in 2011, the fifth highest percentage nationwide among U.S. cities with 65,000 people or more, and 13 times higher than the national average of 0.56%. The 1908 Amtrak depot downtown was restored in 2004. It is the southern terminus for two daily runs of the Amtrak Cascades, and a stop along the route in each direction for the daily Coast Starlight. Air travel is served by the Eugene Airport, also known as McClone Sweet Field, which is the fifth largest airport in the Northwest and second largest airport in Oregon. The Eugene metro area also has numerous private airports. The Eugene metro area also has several heliports, such as the Sacred Heart Medical Center Heliport and McLone Sweetfield Heliport, and many single helipads. Highways traveling within and through Eugene include: Eugene is the home of Oregon's largest publicly owned water and power utility, the Eugene Water and Electric Board, EWEB. Webb got its start in the first decade of the 20th century, after an epidemic of typhoid found in the groundwater supply. The city of Eugene condemned Eugene's private water utility and began treating river water, first the Willamette, later the McKenzie, for domestic use. Webb got into the electric business when power was needed for the water pumps. Excess electricity generated by the Webb's hydropower plants was used for street lighting. Natural gas services provided by NW Natural. Wastewater treatment services are provided by the Metropolitan Wastewater Management Commission, a partnership between the cities of Eugene and Springfield and Lane County. Three hospitals serve the Eugene-Springfield area. Sacred Heart Medical Center University District is the only one within Eugene city limits. McKenzie Willamette Medical Center and Sacred Heart Medical Center at Riverbend are in Springfield. Oregon Medical Group, a primary care-based multi-specialty group, operates several clinics in Eugene, as does Peace Health Medical Group. Whitebird Clinic provides a broad range of health and human services, including low-cost clinics. The Volunteers in Medicine and Occupy Medical Clinics provide free medical and mental care to low-income adults without health insurance. Eugene has four sister cities. Thanks for watching. Don't forget like the video and don't forget to subscribe.